back to Mariankin. So today we'll be looking at metals at the middle of reactivity series and their extraction. That is extraction of metals at the middle of reactivity series. So we find metals at middle of reactivity series such as zinc in two ores, sulfide ore and carbonate ore. So for sulfide ore, we perform roasting. After roasting, we get metal oxide, and after getting metal oxide, we perform the reduction and we get metal. So here we have zinc, sulfide, ZnS. So we know what is roasting. Roasting is heating in the presence of excess air, that is oxygen. We are heating it. We get ZnO plus SO2. So SO2 is a gas which is being evolved. Next is our carbonate ore, which is zinc carbonate. So for converting zinc carbonate to metal oxide, we need to perform calcination. So calcination is heating in the absence of air. In the absence of air, that is without the presence of oxygen, we get ZnO plus CO2, which is also gas, which is evolved. So now, why do we need to convert the sulfide ore and carbonate ore to metal oxide before reduction? So basically, it is easier to reduce ZnO or in metal oxide to the metal, meaning it is easier to extract a metal from metal oxide as compared to sulfide ore or carbonate ore. Hence, prior to reduction, we convert sulfide and carbonate ores to oxide, metal oxide. So on ZnO, we could do two processes of reduction to obtain the metal. We can either use a good reducing agent such as carbon, from which we will get Zn plus Cu, which is carbon monoxide. And the other one is a very important one, which is the displacement reaction, with the help of displacement reaction. So how we do it is that we have the ZnO, zinc oxide. We use a reactive metal, highly reactive metal such as aluminium. So what will aluminium do is that aluminium will replace Zn. So aluminium will replace Zn from oxygen, ZnO. So we'll get Al2O3 and we'll get zinc. So we know that displacement reaction is a very highly exothermic reaction. And in this one, this is also highly exothermic. And so a lot of heat would be produced. So much heat would be produced that the metal produced is in liquid state. It is in liquid state. So based on this principle that it is an exothermic reaction and the metal is produced in liquid state, we use iron, which is Fe2O3 iron oxide. This is ferrous oxide, Fe2O3. This is an oxide of iron 3 oxide. This is iron 3 oxide, so we write 3 as valency. Iron has 2 valency. Iron's valency can either be 2 or 3. So if we write iron 3, that means we are talking about its valency when it is 3. And if we write iron 2, it would be 2. So iron 3 oxide, which is Fe2O3, when we use aluminium. So we know aluminium is more reactive than iron, so it will replace iron. So we will get Al2O3. And Fe, iron, in liquid state plus heat. So since this is produced in liquid state, it is used to join railway tracks made of iron or any other cracks in iron machinery. Hence, this reaction is also called thermite reaction. Thermite reaction. So after obtaining the metal electrolytic refining can be done. So we will learn about electrolytic refining after that, after we have completed the metals at top of the reactivity series.